All right, turn round three here. We're currently 1-1, one against burn and lost to infect. And the burn was mainly like, it's kind of burn with steplings and Kythian. It was kind of weird. Anyways, okay, this sounds great. No vials, but I would easily trade a land or a 3-drop with a vial in this hand. Play this tapped. Pass. Is this burn again? God damn it. Okay, I guess Thalia is great. Pass. Okay. Should be able to win this game. Got a pretty good draw. Think I Fangs here. Fangs, or I could Arbiter and then path like Eidolon. Which is not horrible itself. Although I kinda like just I like just dealing him damage with his own Eidolon. I might actually just lock himself. Yeah, I think I will with this hand. Okay, Stirring Blaze my Thalia. That's reasonable. Still think I win this game. Especially with Volt. So I'll attack him, play another Fangs, and it's probably game over. He might block. He might block with his own Eidolon. I wouldn't be surprised. Doesn't. Alright, you're super dead then. Played Aaron Mesa. I just don't see how it could ever win this. And we can't even activate Volt at this point. I'm not sure this is what I'm gonna do, but we'll see how he blocks. Definitely has to block with at least one creature. So one Goblin Guide, doesn't block with Eidolon. I'm gonna activate it. Damage, I gain infinite. Sure, gain two more. Activating Volt here might have been dangerous though. If he had Tarkas command, I might have lost my turn doing that. But it didn't really matter, I was so ahead. Even if he did play a Tarkas command, I don't think he would get out of that. Alright, so Core Firewalker, Core Firewalker, Brandon. This member's probably not what I want. He's playing a regular burn version. And I want Spellskites. Confidence are out. Some Thought Seizes. I guess I keep it that way. There's still a few cards I would like to board out, such as the mind sensors and the Linvala. I doubt this member is better. Yeah, I really doubt it. Like, unless he's playing the Cattles, even Mind Sensor is essentially the same as this member, because I'm never going to play a life with this member. And if I kill a 2-2, well, my Mind Sensor just does that. And I have Core Flower, Kurt plus Thoughtseize. Just snap keep this hand. Casting Thoughtseize off Quetzalcoatlus feels a little bit too much like standard. But it's been working so far. And we even have Kitchen Finks. In fact, I don't know if I cast Thoughtseize or Path here. One of the upsides of casting Path... Oh no, I just realized this is a Chapel. It's Lady Chapel, so... We can't even cast Core Firewalker on turn 2. Okay. So then I definitely want a path. So hopefully Kitchen Finks, Goblin Guy gives us a sweet basic planes or something like that. Like, in retrospect, I think I should have played the Chapel and just not do anything turn one. Inquisition on top. That's a little bit better than Thoughtseize. Path on turn two is not what I like to be doing. But I'll live with it. Eidolon. Well, it's definitely, it would be quite awful to cast Thoughtseize through Eidolon. But at least we can cast the Inquisition. And then next turn I can play Core Firewalker. And then hopefully Finks at some point. Searing Blaze or Rift Bolt? I'm thinking Rift Bolt. Because Searing Blaze is not going to be very good against our hand. Yeah. So Blaze and Two Foot Ills. Let's play that. Pass. We're down to 12. Chimling Mint. No. Okay, we'll play Core Firewalker. Pass. He didn't play anything in response, so that probably means he didn't have anything to play. Maybe another Singing Blazon or the land he drew. This is a horrible draw. Let's pass. Didn't crack his fetch end of turn, probably keeping it for instant speed landfall. Still no lands, pass. At least we're in a pretty good shape. We might die to a flurry of burn spells. Like, all his burn spells deal 2, basically. So it's not unrealistic that he just kills me in one turn. Or whatever, 2 turns. Vial is awkward. But in the long term, it think in the long term it's good. Like, I'll be able to play everything I have in hand without having to take two per cards. So I think I'm just gonna play it. I'm down to seven. Down to seven means still needs four burn spells, and I know one of his cards is not something he can play because it's Searing Blaze. Hopefully he doesn't have Destructive Revelry. That would blow. Probably didn't have it. Now the question is, if I draw a land, do I actually want to play my Finks or not? I think so. Because it's essentially free because it gives me two life, and I have two Flickerwisps to reset the Finks and gain more life. Sure. Kind of feel like it means I'm dead. Bolt. Sure. Cracks his fetch. And Elix. Aura's Charm, yeah, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, I think I'm dead. Oh yeah, that's pretty sweet. Puts all the trigger on the stack, and then I die. Yes, I try. I try. No, I still die. Alright, bricked a little bit to lose that game, but it happens. So yeah, he's very standard, he has a very, very standard burn list. You haven't even seen a Nicatl. Alright, for this game 3, on the play. And this hand is excellent. Two Finks and a Brand for Forge Chander. We might even get Lun in Orbiter at some point with two Ghost Quarters. Rift Bolt. Bolt sure is suspended. We'll attack. You could have Goblin Guide or Swift Spear or whatever, but I think with double Finks, I'm most likely the beat down more than anything. So far, the mana has been definitely worse than the green-white version. It's hard to tell if Dark Confidant Thoughtseize are actually good since we played against aggressive decks. But I don't hate the deck so far. Eidolon. So does it say next turn or this turn? So that's pretty sweet. I can target Eidolon and then play a bunch of spell in the same turn. I think so. Actually, yeah, I think so. Because it doesn't say next time, it says this turn. Path. It's reasonable. Let's play this Kitchen Finks. And I'm going to keep attacking. Because I truly think I am the beatdown in this game. Yeah, I'll attack with both. Down to 9. Let's play another Fangs. Sure. Gonna be down to 12. I can't gain 2. Yeah, with Eidolon in play, he's kind of lucked out of this game. Yeah, he just scoops. Alright, let's go for a fort round. And he reveals our hand, sure.